First Puma.
Genius.
Then Nike. Two of the biggest sporting brands in the world announcing plans to ditch the Aussie kangaroo leather used in their footy boots in favour of a synthetic alternative.
I think this decision by Nike and Puma needs to be celebrated because they're recognising that in the 21st century, this is not what we should be doing with such an iconic wildlife.
The decision comes after years of campaigning from animal activists.
I was shocked. The kangaroo is considered in Australia a pest.
A push which has seen moves to ban the sale of kangaroo products, including bags, belts, shoes and meat, in Europe and in two US states.
This is not an acceptable wildlife management practice in any nation in the world.
Their main concern? The way the kangaroos are culled.
Up to 40% of the animals that come to the slaughterhouses have been misshot. In other words, they don't die instantly, they die a slow, painful death.
And the treatment of the joeys.
This is this secret that is not talked about in Australia, that every night these dependent joeys are taken from their mother's pouches and bashed to death on the bull bar of the shooter's vehicle.
But the campaign has been branded misinformation by the $200 million a year kangaroo industry, which employs 3,000 Aussies.
It's a flat lie that we're doing what they're saying, bashing joeys against a bull bar. It's just a lie. Animal welfare is at the top of our priorities. The commercial kangaroo industry is ordered, inspected, probably more than any other meat industry in the world.
It says culling kangaroos is the sustainable thing to do, given exploding population numbers across the country.
There's an average of around about 50 million and climbing. So if we don't manage it, you'll have more single car collisions, you'll have more animal welfare problems, and they'll ruin fences, they'll drink water that the cattle and sheep are supposed to be drinking. It'll be an absolute disaster.
Industry insiders insisting not culling roos could undermine the very thing activists are fighting for, animal welfare.
If the commercial industry isn't operating, a lot of these kangaroos, because they multiply so quickly, will just die in some areas a slow and painful death. And nobody wants to see that. Farmers don't want to see that, we don't want to see that, and the Australian population doesn't want to see that.
It's a really tricky situation, isn't it? I wonder if optics play into this, that the world sees kangaroos, this gorgeous creature, you know, we put him on flags and it's on our coat of arms, as too cute. And now they're like, oh, but we actually can't imagine using the meat or the fur from kangaroo. They don't even realise it's a pest across the world. It's kind of like people not eating venison because no one wants to eat Bambi, you know?
Yeah, and I think it's a really complex situation in terms of, you know, managing grazing lands, managing pasture. Anytime you kill an animal or you cull an animal for meat or for fur or for leather, there's ethical issues around it, whether it's kangaroos or whether it's beef or whether it's sheep or crocodiles. So, you know, it's a really deep conversation that this country needs to have in terms of its farming practices as well.
But this isn't farming. This is the opposite of farming. Like, you know,
you can't farm
how do you
them.
Farm a kangaroo?
No, yeah. That's true, but there's that headbutt in between the kangaroos and the grazing as well, yes. Which is, you know, all around farming practices.
Yeah, I see.